Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
My father was a wonderful, creative, incredible person who gave the world something that will never be taken away.
All of the other reindeer.
He never, ever would have imagined that it would be what it is today.
Martha May and Betsy Decker are the youngest of Robert L. May's six children and call Chicago's northern suburbs home.
My house is full of reindeer. I have every ornament, every little collectible.
Here's the original.
Oh my gosh.
That I saved. We feel very fortunate. There are a lot of things we couldn't do, wouldn't have college educations for one, if it weren't for Rudolph. The house we grew up in, my dad called it the house that Rudolph built.
Back in the 30s, Robert L. May was an advertising copywriter for Montgomery Ward. His boss asked him to come up with a little something the store could give away at Christmas time. At that time, a red nose was associated with heavy drinking, not the kind of image Ward's was looking for, so the boss rejected the little red-nosed reindeer. But Robert May had another idea and told this story on the radio in 1964.
I then went to the artist and persuaded him to go with me to the Lincoln Park Zoo in Chicago to see if he couldn't work up some sketches of a little red-nosed reindeer that would not be repulsive or suggesting of too many drinks. The artist did a very good job, and thanks to those sketches, I was able to convince the boss that it could be handled properly.
With illustrations firmly in place, Robert L. May finished his story of the little reindeer who was picked on for being different.
Ha ha, look at Rudolph. His nose is a sight. It's red as a beet, twice as big, twice as bright.
You say the story's biographical.
In many ways it is. The character had to overcome some negative aspects, obviously the red nose. My father, he grew up in a time where his parents skipped many grades, and so by the time he got to Dartmouth College, he was very small, incredibly, incredibly brilliant, but small.
In the original book, Rudolph is sound asleep when Santa enters his room and recruits him on a foggy Christmas Eve. This note Rudolph wrote to his parents is in May's own handwriting.
I need you, said Santa, to help me tonight, to lead all my deer on the rest of our flight. He put his heart and soul into a comic book that he was really getting nothing for. Millions of copies were given away. It turned into something huge that has changed Christmas, has changed, I think, how kids feel about themselves.
For 10 years, the book did well.
All of the other reindeer.
But it was the song, written a decade later by May's brother-in-law, Johnny Marks, that made Rudolph a superstar.
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
It will be an honor, sir.
By the 25th anniversary, Rudolph the Animagic movie was made by Arthur Rankin, songwriter Johnny Marks' next-door neighbor. Though Montgomery Ward could have kept the copyright, they rewarded their loyal and talented employee by signing over all Rudolph's rights to May and his family.
Do you tell people?
My dad did that. We were really, really discouraged from doing that as kids, and when people do find out about it, most people don't believe it anyway.
Call it a coincidence, but what are the chances that while we were reminiscing, three deer stopped by to say hi? All part of the magic of growing up May.
The story of Rudolph tells kids, take your worst attribute, turn it into something good, be proud of what you've got, and that's a message that will go on forever.
You go down in history.